Hi, my name is Gary Bergero, and I'm a mechanical solutions engineer at Hagerman. In this tech tip, we'll take a look at AutoCAD 2021's annotation scaling. Annotation scaling is a useful tool for creating a final sheet of paper of a model that has multiple viewports and scale factors. This model here has a small detail in the lower left corner and another detail over here. I'd like to create a final sheet of paper with a model view, a 1-to-1, a detail view, maybe something like 2-to-1 here, and another detail view, 4-to-1. Then I'd like to add annotation, whether it be dimensions, text, or hatching, and have it be a reasonable scale factor for plotting. So we want a clean sheet of paper. Okay, so we'll jump over to layout 1 and enter paper space. When you enter a paper space, AutoCAD will automatically create one viewport for you. So it created one viewport. You can move it around. You could stretch it with grips. I left my current layer as viewports since I was aware of that. And then I've got one viewport here and I can go and create additional ones. So go over to the layout tab and I'd like to create some viewports where eventually I'll focus on the details. So we'll use a rectangular viewport. And it'll take about a quarter of the page. Okay, and we'll do a third viewport for the other detail. Okay, so we've got the three necessary viewports. And then I'll activate a viewport and focus on different things. So we'll start here. One way to activate a viewport is double click, and then I can pan and zoom and get the model the way I want it. So I want a full view of the model, and then I'll come back for scaling. Then I'll pick here for this view, I'd like to focus on this detail, but leave room for dimensions or text. And then in this viewport, I'd like to focus on this detail, which I call that detail 2. Okay, so we've taken care of that task. And now on to scale factors. We'll activate this viewport. On the status bar in the bottom of AutoCAD, you'll see a number here towards the right side of your screen. And this is called VP scale. And you could set the viewport to any scale factor. They give you some standard scale factors and you can create your own. So I'll choose 1-to-1. And then check how it does them with the model. I can still pan, but I shouldn't zoom at this point because I've got it at 1-to-1. If I zoom, it would throw off the scale factor. Then I activate this viewport, and I'd like to set that at 2-to-1, see what it looks like. So we'll come down to this number, set it to 2-to-1, and I can still pan, and I can have room for text and dimensions. We'll activate this viewport and set it to 4-to-1. Okay, so we've accomplished that task. We've got three different scale factors on the same sheet of paper. So we'll leave floating model space and go back to paper space. Okay, now we're interested in text or dimensions that would look nice on the sheet of paper with multiple scale factors. So I go back to the Home tab, and I do have a layer for dimensioning with a different color. So I'll choose dimensions, get that ready to go. And now on to our topic. We would like to dimension and control the scale factors. So in 2021, we'll go over here to the Annotate tab. And wanted to point out where styles are located in the newer versions of AutoCAD. So for example, here's my text area, but this lower down arrow, there's a text style. Here's the dimension area. Notice this down arrow, dimension style, and that's what we'll be using. Notice it's the same over here. If I go to leader, there's leader style. And if I go over here, table style. So you want to look for your style commands as the lower right arrows on each panel there. Okay, so go over to dimension style. And in 2021, the current dimension style is standard, which is a small mechanical style, 4 decimal places. They do have an annotative style that comes with the software as well, but it's probably easier to understand the topic if we create our own from scratch. So I'll choose new, and I'll use a special name. I'm gonna call it My Annotative Dimension Style. Okay, and then here's the trick. We're creating a special dimension style that should do our scale factors for us. So as we check annotative, that will read the viewport scale factor. So there's the important topic for multiple scales. I'll choose continue. It becomes the current style. And we'll just do one other variable. So I'd like to set it to 2 decimal places instead of 4 decimal places. So I go to primary units, change that. Now I'll show you the end result. I'll hit OK. Here's that style that we were creating. Notice the blue triangular icon. In the old days, we used to use a triangular ruler to do scale factors. On each face of the ruler, it would have a different scale factor that you can lay on a sheet of paper and check your work. And then if you flipped the triangular ruler to another face, you'd be able to check it with a different scale factor. So this icon is a side view of the old style triangular rulers with multiple scale factors. So that way you know it's a special style and it's going to handle scale factors for you. So that's ours, and notice that it's current and 2 decimal places as well. So go ahead and hit close and we'll use that style. The interesting thing about annotative scaling is where do you put your dimensions? And the answer is inside the floating viewports. So I'll double click on this one to activate it and go back to the home tab. We're still on the dimension layer, and we'll do the new dimension command here. So do dimension, and I'll just start with endpoint to endpoint. So I'll pick here and here and place 6-inch dimension. And this model is a small mechanical model that is 6 inches. So there you get to see what that typical dimension looks like. And we'll do one more up here. I'll just go from endpoint to endpoint. The interesting thing is notice I dimensioned the left side of the model. Well, this is the left side of the model over here. And notice that the dimension doesn't show up. So it's reading the scale factor 1-to-1, and these are dimensions for 1-to-1 viewports. Okay, we'll do one more 3-inch dimension here at the bottom. So I'll just select this entity and place it. Notice I dimensioned the bottom of the model and the dimension does not show up over here. So these are looking a reasonable size, reasonable text size and arrow size and gaps. I'll come over here, a different scale factor, and add some dimensions. The interesting thing is notice the size of the arrowheads and the text, that they're the same size as the other view, but this model is blown up 2-to-1. We'll activate this viewport. And this viewport, I'll remind you, is 4-to-1. And these are the correct dimension sizes and values for that detail. Okay, so we've accomplished that task of dimensioning 3 different scale factors, and we'll switch back to paper space and say we've finished that task. Okay, I did create my viewports on their own layer, which is dark blue. I'll show you. So I do have a viewports layer, so we can turn that off and print the drawing with or without the viewports. So we'll leave them on for this simple exercise. So the goal here is printing and having a reasonable sheet of paper that you can read the dimensions even on the details. So it's looking good. So we'll say that paper space is going to come out nice when we print it. There's one more thing to take a look at before we complete this tooltip. So we'll go back to the model tab. And over in the model tab, doesn't look so good. Here's the 1-to-1 dimensions. And then the 2-to-1 dimensions are here, and then the 4-to-1 dimensions. So if I did send this drawing to someone else, they wouldn't be too happy with me at the moment because they're seeing some strange looking dimensions, but we can fix that. So the last thing you want to do after doing annotation scaling is come over to the original model space and learn one more icon. So down at the bottom of the screen, it's called the status bar. And notice these icons here. We were talking about the side view of a triangular ruler. So here's the interesting one. It's showing all annotation objects, which is 1:1, 2:1, 4:1. Well, I don't want to send this over to a vendor or customer. So what you do is single click here. It turns off the scale dimensions and we'll just leave you with the 1:1 dimensions. So this is reasonable. If my team understands annotation scaling and they know our final print comes from paper space with multiple views, they would be aware of this and they're okay with having just the model view show the 1:1 dimensions. So it's reasonable. Excuse me. So we can send this out, and if people on the team understand it, so main goal is they know we're going to plot from here and get something that looks nice. So hopefully you've seen the power of annotation scaling and the final sheet of paper looking good. And thank you for your time.